Very good morning. Today we'll discuss about the user profiles. So after this lecture, you are able to know what are the different types of user profiles, why we need to profiling the users. So firstly, whenever you are going to design an interface, you have to know the what are the diversity may be present in your interface. Okay. So designer to build the several community of user for a system. No single design in fact can satisfy all kind of situations. Okay. And designer face real challenge to cater the need of each community. So basically, whatever the software you will design, that may not be fulfilled for every users. The types of different types of user may have required different category. Okay, so you have to intelligently identify one solutions that may be suitable for each of them. So there are the three important characteristics. One is user profiles, that is diversification of users, different one kind of profile of the user having same kind of activity or same kind of needs. Then task profile and the interaction style. Okay. Similar way, tasks can be different types. One, interaction style also different types. We have already discussed five different types of classical interaction styles. And every interaction styles having some merits and demerits. So the main objective of the user profile is know the users. So user profile or user situation may be varied due to their age, gender, physical ability, education, cultural or ethnic background, maybe for training and motivation, and maybe personality. So some people who are educated or came from different sociological culture, they may have different kind of needs. For this type of user, for you have to require some special kind of options in your software. So getting to know the user is a never ending process, because there are so much to know and because they are keep changing. Okay, so it is very difficult to get all type of users. Okay, so when you are going for testing a particular system, it is also really difficult to get all different types of users, and sometimes the same category of user may have some percentage of diversifications. Okay, but you have to satisfy as much as user can be possible. So in a generic division, we can divide it users into three different groups. One is novice or first time user, another is intermediate user, another is expert user. So novice user, basically they don't have any knowledge about the task, what he have to perform in any particular interface or any particular software. Okay, they are basically unaware about the software, and also they are unaware about how to use that particular software. Sometimes they often may anxious about the computer and its functionality. It is very, very common things. Okay, if a layman came to use the computers, they may be feel fear how to use it. Okay, what are the different functions? They may think that if I touch into the keyboard, then something can be happened. So they having a fear or anxiousness in their mind. The next category of user is intermediate user. So they have limited knowledge on the task or the interface concept. Okay, they are not the first time user, but they are also not the master user. They are used to these things, but they are not the master user. They have a little bit idea. So that is the intermediate users. Okay, and expert users. So they are thoroughly familiar with the task and the interface concept, and they can perform the task, whatever task assigned to them, quickly. Okay, like the people, those who are educated to the technical educations, those who are software developer. Okay, basically those who are use the particular system daily or frequently, they are the frequent user or expert users. They having the mastery on the control, okay, they can do their job very fast. So for the novice user, if you are going to design an interface, then the number of action should be small and informatic feedback should be accompanied for the each task that is helpful. Okay, so whenever the you design a novice user, so you have to find out, you have to design in such a way that number of actions like mouse click, maybe key press, okay, maybe form filling, okay, will be the less. So the job have to be complying with less number of steps, okay, and after completion of step sometimes required a feedback, and that feedback have to be constructive feedback, okay, that is not the very large feedback, it is a short and simple constructive feedback. And constructive and specific error message should be there. When they are perform any error, so you should notify them with a error message, and the error message should be should be shown in such a way that will be, it will be helpful for them in future purpose. Okay, so suggestion of the rectification should be there, and it should be carefully designed. Paper manual and step-by-step online tutorial may be effective. So obviously some kind of manual or online tutorial should be, you have to prepare, and that tutorial have to be prepared in such a way, in a very intelligent way. Intelligent way means that will be that there should be some little amount of the text descriptions, there should be some pictorial descriptions, okay, so how much portion they have required, you only write the write that much portion. It should be concrete and it should be brief, okay, it's not a hugely large, and it should be clear cut, understanding will be there. Whenever you prepare for the intermediate users, so what are the structure, menus, consistent terminology, high interface appearance, which emphasize recognize rather than recall. So you have to have used one idea, that is they can easily recognize the interface rather than the recall. Okay, so there is a concept, recognize and recall, we'll discuss future in the unit number 4. Okay, so recognize basically by seeing the interface they are recognize whatever the task and how the task will be performed. Okay, but with a so it should be consistent sequence of action, meaningful message, guides to frequent pattern of usage should be there. Okay, so online help, skin to fill the meaning pieces of tasks, interface knowledge, and well organized reference manual also be useful. So here you have to design in such a way that it should be consistent, okay, that people will easily identified what will be the step. If it is inconsistent, then there is a chance of error will be there. Okay, and it should be well organized and reference should be constructive. Okay, so it's basically in the case of intermediate user, you should design in such a way your interface that after looking the interface they can identify how to do their work, they can recognize how to do that work. Okay, and for the expert user, the interface should be designed in such a way that work have been done in quickly. Okay, so there should be a rapid response, okay, should be there, brief and non feedback, and sometimes feedback is not required, okay, but only thing that you can use the shortcut key, you can use the keyboard also, okay, but have the work need to be done very fast, so they capable to carry out action just a few keystroke or selections. Okay, you can use the command, okay, shortcut menus, abbreviations, all that things you can use for the expert users. So that's the thing. So three different types of users. For novice users, the interface should be very simple, and it should have a less number of steps. An intermediate user, you have designed in such a way that they can understand the interface, okay, and feedback also constructive. And the expert user, you have to design the interface that it is they can perform there with a very fast speed. Okay, you can use any shortcut, any menu, okay, or any commands you can use. So for the rating, you can go for a book for the Venn syndrome. The title of the book is Design the User Interface, Strategy and Effective for Human Computer Interaction. Or if you have any query, you can mail me with my mail ID, that is romanlo.course@calcuttauniversity.edu.in. Thank you for listening to me.